Make up our minds to do the right thing in this life. In our chance, Allah's name do we sing. Allah, 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 Ya Allah.
Bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقده من لساني يفقهوا قولي اما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. Welcome to a new episode with Only If You Knew, talking about Allah's beautiful names. And today inshallah we're going to talk about one of Allah's beautiful names that many people refer to, but the thing is many people refer to it without really fully believing in it. Many of us, we ask Allah to make us amongst those who live it. May Allah make us amongst those who believe in it and fulfill it, its requirements as much as we can. That name we'll tell you inshallah after we introduce our dear guests. Can you please go ahead and mention your name and where you're from?
My name is Ahmed, I'm from the USA.
My name is Asmir and I'm from Bosnia.
Great.
So, my name is Nabil, I'm from Egypt.
Nice to meet you, Nabil.
My name is Omar from Egypt and I'm lucky to be here with you.
Allah, we're the ones who are lucky, alhamdulillah, to be here together as brothers inshallah, lucky to talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, it's a beautiful thing. Remember that the majesty of a nobility of a study or a science is dependent on the object of study, which means the doctor and the engineer. I mentioned this at the beginning, I mentioned this at the end. Doctor and engineer, which one is a little higher? What do you think is higher, Nabil?
Doctor.
The doctor or engineer? Go ahead.
Doctor,
right? Why? Because the object of study, he studies on human beings. Because human beings are so noble, his job or his status becomes preferred over the engineer that works on machines. They imagine those whom their object of study is Allah's beautiful names. They become over the engineer, over the doctor, because they're studying Allah's beautiful names. May Allah make us amongst those. But don't quit your job and just do this. Yani do both and be balanced. Tayyib, today's beautiful name. There's a alim by the name of Shaqiq al-Balkhi. He wasn't of the best Muslims at the beginning of his life. Shaqiq al-Balkhi, what made him repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ignited that thought, as he was walking in a city, it was a year of drought. No food much, not a drink, no rain. It was very, very tough. And everybody around was going through harsh times. He saw a young boy who was walking and he's so happy and smiling. He said, "Ya ghulam, what made you happy like that? What made you excited? What makes you like not upset and sad and depressed?" He said, "I am a slave of a master." Because there's Abid and Mamalik or like Malik and so on at that time. And then Sayyid basically. And then they say, "You know what? I'm going to give you from the food which I eat. You're going to sleep in the house which I have," and so on. So he told them, "My master is very rich and wealthy, and he has a lot of food in his village, so I'm not worried." So then Shaqiq talked to himself. He said, "He has a master that has a village, and he felt safe towards it, and he doesn't feel that he's going to go like basically die out of hunger and so on. And my Lord is the one who owns the heavens and the earth, and I'm worried. And my Lord is the one who has khazain as-samawati wal-ard, and this is what I go through." And from that point, he says, "This is what changed my life. Only if you knew Allah, Ar-Razzaaq, the provider, will you have that beautiful life, that life of comfort, that life of Ar-Razzaaq subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you're never worried." What does rizq mean? Rizq, I mentioned it very simple. It is every provision, every share that a human being or any creation would need, whether tangible or intangible, maddi or hissi. That's rizq, something which you need to survive and to sustain your life. What does Ar-Razzaaq mean? Very simple. The one that delivers these provisions. He is the one who delivers it. There's also Allah's beautiful name, Ar-Razzaaq. So Ar-Razzaaq and Ar-Razzaaq. So what's more excessive? What's more extreme?
Ar-Razzaaq,
excellent. So like there wasn't what? Fa'al. Great. So Ar-Razzaaq, Rasulullah, some people would like to know, where did we get Allah's name Ar-Razzaaq? Because we said Asma' la tawqifiyya, which means that we have to bring it only from the Quran and Sunnah and not from our own mind. It's like, you know what, Allah's name is this and that. The authentic hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to Rasulullah. Rasulullah says, "Inna Allaha huwa al-musa'iru al-qabidu al-basitu al-raziq." So authentic hadith. So I'll translate it for you. Al-raziq is the one who sustains, and al-musa'ir is the one who raises, increases, and decreases. Basically here it says the prices of things and so on. This musa'ir. Al-qabid is the one who withholds, and al-basit is the one who gives lavishly in big amounts. And Ar-Razzaaq is the sustainer or the provider. And Ar-Razzaaq is the more extreme cases. The point of this talk is for you to have confidence. That's the main part of this, is for you to have so much confidence that the one who provides to you is not your boss. The one who gives you that check is not your manager at work. The one who gives you the food is not really your mom. Rather, it's Allah that blessed your mother with that food that's in the fridge. Allah is the only source of rizq. He called himself Ar-Razzaaq. He gives sustenance and provision to the obedient and disobedient. He gives it to the human being and the animal and every living creature. He gives it to the Muslim and the kafir or the non-Muslim. Are you serious? Absolutely. Remember, subhanAllah, very beautiful verse in the Quran. Allah subhanAllah says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قال إبراهيم رب اجعل هذا بلدا آمنا O Allah, make this city what? A safe place. What else, Ya Ibrahim? What is it you're asking for? وارزق وارزق أهله من الثمرات So all those in the Ahl in Mecca, he specified as من آمن منهم بالله واليوم الآخر So he sees, Ibrahim, that those who deserve it are only the believers. What does Allah say afterwards? قَالَ وَمَنْ كَفَرْ Allah says, وَمَنْ كَفَرْ We'll also give them. Ya Allah the Kuffar, because He's the Lord of the Kafir and the Muslim. Allah says, قَالَ وَمَنْ كَفَرْ فَأُمَتِّعُهُ قَلِيلًا I'll give them the provision in this dunya. قَلِيلًا And then, ثُمَّ أَطَّرُّهُ إِلَى عَذَابِ النَّارِ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرِ Then Allah gets them to Jahannam and they get what they deserve. So the Lord of the Muslim, the Lord of the Kafir, the only source of rizq is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's so sad is when people limit the rizq into money, which is incorrect. When it comes to rizq, there's rizq hissi and rizq, what's the opposite of hissi? Ma'nawi. Excellent. So which means tangible or intangible. So we are in body and soul, your body and your heart. Body, it can be health. That's rizq. Sahallah. What else can be like a physical benefit or physical rizq? Food. Isn't that right? What else?
Drink.
Being handsome, mashallah. Beautiful, handsome brothers, mashallah, here. May Allah protect all of us. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. From Ayn and Hasan, mashallah. Beautiful. So this is ni'mah, sah? This is the rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. What else, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The sun rays. Yeah. The sun, isn't it rizq to us?
Yeah.
Allah rizq more and more. Now give me some rizq that is intangible. Hissi.
Happiness,
sa'adah. Beautiful.
Iman.
Excellent. Islam, beautiful,
knowledge.
Great.
Huh? Knowledge.
College?
Knowledge.
Exactly. Knowledge. Excellent. Ilm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanAllah, He gives dunya to whomever He loves and to whomever He does not love. أن الله يعطي الدنيا, that's a hadith, authentic. إن الله يعطي الدنيا لمن يحب ولمن لا يحب. ولا يعطي الإيمان إلا لمن يحب. And He doesn't give iman except to those whom He loved. May Allah make us amongst those whom He loved. We ask Allah al-wadud. Ameen rabbal alameen. Iman, all this is all rizq. So we have to pay attention when Ar-Razzaaq, don't limit Allah's names. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a vast, He gives as much as He wants. I'll mention 5 points of to increase your confidence in Ar-Razzaaq. It's only Ar-Razzaaq that gives you. Do not humiliate yourself. Do not sell your religion to someone else just for the sake of a paycheck, for the sake of this, for the sake of knowledge, to go to college, and whatever it is. For example, there's a brother, a true story. He is from the western area, and I know the story like secondhand from a brother who I heard. He said that man went to the job. His name is Muhammad. As he went for the interview, the man was calling him, oh, Mr. Muhammad, how are you doing? He's like, no, you can call me Mo. Okay. I'm not saying it's haram. I'm just saying that he just, khalas, doesn't want the Muhammad, no problem. Mashi. Or maybe it's haram, Allah knows best. This, we give it to the fuqaha, to the ulama to discuss. Call me Mo. So he wears, shaves his beard. I'm also not saying it's haram or sunnah. It's not the fiqh class. But this is the way he looks. Then he says, so Muhammad, I see, or Mo, sorry about that. Mo, you're qualified for the position. You have the requirements. Excellent, great. I think you will do a great job. And Mo, you're a Muslim. And I see that you pray your Friday, 5 daily prayers, and you go to Friday for an hour. Huh? Isn't that right? He said, oh, don't worry about the hour on Friday. Don't worry about it. I don't have to go. He said, why? He's like, you know what? I just make sure we get the job. It's fine. You know what? Don't worry about the prayers. We'll take care of it. Something personal. Don't worry about it. So the man says, okay. The interview is done. Then he said, we'll give you a call if we confirm that you got the position. So Mo, he felt comfortable. The khalas, I got the position because we had good stuff at the beginning. 2 weeks later, he doesn't get a call. Many weeks later, he doesn't get anything. He calls them back. He said, hello. Not assalamu alaikum. Hello. My name is such and such. My name is Mo. I came in. I had an interview. What was the result? So the manager said, sorry, we're not going to give you the position. He said, why? He said, how can we trust someone in our job when he's not even loyal to his own religion? You're not even loyal to your religion. How can you be loyal to your job and position? In his face, subhanAllah, only if you know Ar-Razzaaq, that Allah would have provided him, not perhaps in this one, but in another job. We ask Allah to guide him. See, Ameen, Ameen. We shouldn't be excited that, you know what, Alhamdulillah didn't get the job. Because it was funny, subhanAllah. But so we ask Allah to bless all of the brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to believe that he is Ar-Razzaaq, just like how you believe he is Al-Khaliq. Just like how you believe no one else created the world except Allah, believe that he is also Ar-Razzaaq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. That one of the most important ayat in the Quran. Every ayat is important, but this one shows our purpose in life. Look what Allah says afterwards. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَن يُطْعِمُونَ. I don't want risk from you. I don't want food from you. I only want you to worship me. صح? Then Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ. Right after al-khalq, right after the purpose of our creation. إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Allah is al-razzaq. Allah provides you. Allah, pay attention to this one. Allah made our purpose what? To worship Allah. And he made the asbab, the means, is the risk that he provides. So we can go and achieve our goal. Some people these days, they switched it. They make their life as means to achieve risk. La, risk are means to achieve the goal, which is the purpose of your life. But some people are so burdened, they think Allah is not Ar-Razzaq, or they forget. But only if they know Ar-Razzaq will their life change. Look at this other ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu alladhi khalaqakum thumma razaqakum thumma yumitukum thumma yuhyikum. Allah is al-khaliq, Allah is al-razzaq. Then he says, hal min shurakaikum. Do you have anyone else that can do exactly what Allah does? He creates you, he provides for you, he brings you to life and he brings you to death. Look at the maximum. Al-razzaq, don't forget. Wake up, wake up. Can anyone else do what Allah does? وَتَعَالَ اللَّهُ عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Allah is free from such accusations. SubhanAllah. We'll continue more of increasing your confidence. Don't look right, don't look left, don't sell your deen. لا تبيع دينك. Don't ever do that, because Allah is Ar-Razzaq. We'll continue inshallah after a short break, so please be patient. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So let's make up our minds to do the right thing in this life. In our chance, Allah's name do we sing.
Ramadan is here.
We're only a few sunsets away from the month of change, an opportunity that is given to us only once a year. Take a look at this. Take a look at your future. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's a very windy and dusty day here. We're about an hour out of Cairo in the middle of the desert. Al-ikhlas, sincerity. Whether you are alone in the middle of the ocean, in a boat, or on a river, or in a busy city street, your only way to success in this life and the next is through sincerity.
Methanol, which is the fuel that is used for rockets, that is placed inside cigarettes, that we're putting into our bodies when we're breaking our fast. SubhanAllah.
Together, let's plant the seeds. The seeds of change.
Seeds of change.
Let's make up our minds to do the right thing in this life. In our chance, Allah's name do we sing.
Allah's beautiful name, Razzaq. Allah's beautiful name, Razzaq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who live with Allah, Razzaq. Also, I'd like to thank you for being patient through the break. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. And may Allah make your heart attached only to Razzaq and not allow you to go and humiliate yourself and humble yourself to someone just for the sake of money while doing things that are haram. There's a person that I learned from him, subhanAllah, here, that works with our channel, mashallah. May Allah reward him, without mentioning any names. He said that he used to work for a big company that they do movies and theaters and masrahiyat, etc. and all that stuff. And he used to be among those who work with the cameras or recording and sound. One time I said, what makes you change to Islamic channel? Big difference. And generally, which is not, subhanAllah, that's how it happens over the world, that those who work in Islamic sectors don't get paid as much as those who work in different things, subhanAllah. So what made you do that big jump? He said, as I was working on the sound and so on, I heard there was a sister, there was a girl that was there that was working. The director asked her to show some of her body. So she showed some of her body. Then he said, no, I want more. Reveal yourself, more skin for the camera, subhanAllah. Then he said that she was crying because she did not want to do it. She only was here for what? For the money. She was here just for the money and she doesn't want to do it. She knows it's wrong. I can't show my body more than this. Khalas, khalas. He said, no, you want to work? Go ahead. They started crying. Then when that man saw this, he's like, what kind of humiliation we're going through? What is it that we're going through? As if he's the one who gives rizq, the director. No, it's not. So in that time, he said, you know what? I felt so bad. I took off everything and I said, Ya Allah, I'm going to quit my job. He used to make so much money, mashallah. Then at that point, when he took away, the director and people came to him and said, what are you doing? He said, I'm going to leave. Okay, what other job are you going? He's like, don't worry about it. I'm done. Do you have any substitute? I don't have a substitute. Allah, Ar-Razzaaq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do you think he will let go of him? Do you think he will let go of him? No. He left something for Allah. Will Allah let go of him? Impossible. You leave something for your friend will never forget it for you and he will return it one day. Sah? Yeah. He will appreciate it. Rasulullah s.a.w. teaches us this. You leave something for Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for that and give you something that is even better. 2 days later, what happens? That person gets a call from Huda channel. 2 days later, they call and they said, we want someone that does such and such, so if you please, you know, mashallah, you're famous, you're known, so ask someone if you know that to come. He tells them, I left my job, so I can do that job. And I talked to him right now, and I said, and you went? He's like, yeah, what do you see? For the past many years, I'm here. I'm like, Allahu Akbar. He said, wallahi, I've never tasted as much happiness and sweetness in my job as much as this. What is more beautiful than da'wah? And imagine how people say shahada on TV, get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine all of this. I'm like, what about the pay? He's like, wallahi, the pay is less, but I feel there's more barakah in that big pay that I used to get. It's Ar-Razzaaq, brothers. It's Ar-Razzaaq, sisters, brothers and watching, subhanAllah. Ar-Razzaaq, increase your confidence in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the second point, Allah already wrote your rizq. It's done. It's done. Don't go kill yourself. It's done. Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. Everything we create with qadr. Everything has been written. When was it written? We mentioned Allah al-Khaliq. Remember? It has been written 50,000 years before Allah created the heavens and the earth. 50,000 years قبل خلق السماوات والأرض. When Allah created the pen. To write and write. So khalas, rizq is written. So there's no need to go to other avenues and things that are haram. Look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah assigns an angel in the rahim, the womb of the mother. There's a special angel. What does that angel do? When the husband and the wife, this is authentic hadith, they enjoy their night and may Allah bless and reward those subhanAllah that do it in a halal fashion. And Allah will reward them just like we mentioned in the previous hadith. The sahaba said, Ya Allah, we get rewarded for putting our sexual desires with our wives. The Prophet ﷺ said, Na'am, you do, because those who do it in a haram fashion, they get punished. You do it in a halal fashion, Allah will reward you. So after that night, the angels ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ay Rabb, nutfah, Ya Allah, should I allow the sperm of the man and the egg of the woman to fertile? Should I allow them to touch each other? Or should I not make it happen and let them just make a night where they get the reward and that's it? Ya Ay Rabb, nutfah. If Allah says yes, make it nutfah. Then the angel says, Ya Rabb, alaqa. Oh Allah, shall I make it alaqa? Should we move it to the next level? To a clot? If Allah allows it, then it becomes a clot. Ya Allah, should I make it a clot and cling to the womb of the mother? Or should I make the mother have a miscarriage? If Allah wills it to continue, then let it continue. Then the angel says, Ay Rabb, mudgha. Should I make it like a mudgha? You know, you chew, like a chewing part, and you see it, subhanAllah, now in the TV and so on, in the embryology, you see exactly as if someone is chewing a piece of flesh. If Allah says yes, then it happens. Then, that's the third question. There's four more questions. When Allah wills this to happen, He said, Ya Allah, what's the rizq that I should write for that man? A dhakar am untha? Second question, out of the four. So now we mentioned, what's the first one? Ay Rabb nutfa, Ay Rabb alaqa, Ay Rabb mudgha. Allah says yes, yes, then you move forward to the next level. Now maybe the baby is 8 months or so, and then, Ya Rabb, dhakar am untha, should I make a male or female? Then Allah chooses the gender. So don't complain about Allah Ar-Razzaaq. He's the one who chose the gender. Then he says, Ya Allah, Shaqi am Sa'id? Is he or she going to be amongst the happy ones or the ones that are going to Jahannam or Jannah? Allah says the future. Not, he did not force you, but Allah knows the unseen. He knows the position. And the other two questions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask, let me just make sure. خَلَقْنَاهُ وَمُدْغَةً نَعْمْ مَثَلْ أَجَلْ When will they die? How old will they reach? How far they will go? فَيَكْتُبُ فِي بَطْنِ أُمِّهِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention those and then everything will be written. So the rizq is what? Is already written. نطفة علقة مضغة ذكر أم أنثى شقي أم سعيد and the risk and when will they die? Seven questions. So you're already done when you're already in your mother's womb. It's done. So why are we going to different places and seeking ways that are improper? Just increasing your confidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already made this happen. Look at Rasulullah ﷺ under that thing about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already written decree your risk. Rasulullah ﷺ said, don't forget, إِنَّ رُوحَ الْقُدُسِ نَفَثَ فِي رُوعِ رُوحَ الْقُدُسِ جِبْرِيلَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ has inspired Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم that لَن تَمُوتَ نَفْسٌ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ رِزْقَهَا The nafs will not die until the risk is completed. Whatever is written will be given to that person. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ So fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that if you, Allah wrote to you that you will 7,966 times you will have 7,966 times. You will not die before losing that last breath. Is it clear? If Allah wrote, you will have $10.02. You have the $10.02. You will not lose that ajr. You will not lose that risk that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. Just pay attention and remember those events that take place. And I'm sure you know people that when they left something that is wrong, those who humiliate themselves and then they move to the next level, Allah provides to them because Allah named Himself Ar-Razzaaq. Look at the other part. Number one was what? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala... Do you remember the first point? What was the first point? The second point is Allah already decreed that its rizq is happening. Number one is that you need to believe that Allah is al-Razzaq just how you believe Allah is al-Khalaq. The third one that I'd like to mention is that Allah tells you, I provide to the animals. I will not provide to you. Allah says, وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا There's not a single animal on earth except that Allah provides. Why would Allah tell us this? I'm going to give to the animals and I'm going to forget about you. You, yeah, human being, oh human being, you who I created with my own hands. Allah made Adam with his own hands. وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ And Allah blew from his own soul and he made the angels prostrate to our father Adam. Allah gives the animals and forget about you? Never, never. So Allah encourages us to know more about this. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions another verse about the animals and about us to think, like ponder, تَفَكَّرُوا وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا SubhanAllah, forgive us. وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا And what animal carries its own risk? What animal? No animal carries its own risk. Very few, perhaps they do, but most of them, they just walk and there's no bag. You see an animal with a backpack? No. You see, no lunchbox. So Allah says they don't even carry themselves. Ya Allah, مَنْ يَرْزُقْهَا الله يرزقها وإياكم Allah provides to the animals وإياكم you wake up رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم teaches us had we have tawakkul in Allah the way the birds have tawakkul Allah will fill our stomachs and will protect us and will provide to us just like how the birds they go with empty stomachs and they come back with full stomachs they did not go with a lunchbox Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you to think about it Your risk is in the heavens. Point number four. Your risk is already written. Your Ar-Razzaaq is just like Al-Khaliq. It has been written in the past. Number three, Allah gives the animals. Will He forget about you? Number four, the risk is not even on earth. Where's the risk? If it's not on earth, then it's where? In the heavens. What's the proof? Allah says, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ And the heavens is your risk. So no one will take it from here. No one will steal it. You're like, Yahi, what do you mean? What heaven are you talking about? The rizq is in dunya, brother. What are you talking about? The computers are here. The cameras are here. My store is in dunya. My bank account is in dunya. You say rizq is in sama? You misunderstood. Everything here is asbab, means to attain the rizq that is above the seven heavens. Is it clear? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, rizq is in sama. Don't worry, no one will steal it. Don't go fight. No, I'll fight for the position. I'll fight for the position. If you go, then I will lose my chances. Taqillah ya akhi. Risk is already written. You take the means and then you move forward. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide the best for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says after that verse, فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٍّ. You know, Al-A'rabi, he heard the first verse, that what? That sama' the رِزْقُكُمْ فِي السَّمَاءِ. He heard that and he believed in it. The next verse, Allah swears that your rizq is in the heavens. فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٍّ. The A'rabi said, who made Allah angry? I already believed. Who made Allah angry? Who caused Allah to swear? Does Allah have to swear? Subhanallah. That's how important, because the brothers and sisters, some of us, we're so attached to the dunya and the people that we think if we leave the job that's haram, that selling alcohol, that's it, we're done. La wallahi, never, ever. As I was traveling here to Egypt, there was a flight attendant. She was selling and giving alcohol, khamr. I told her, do you realize how dangerous this is? She says, yeah, I know. I'm like, do you have any incidents that happen, any events that people end up getting drunk because they keep going back and forth selling khamr, every back and forth? I'm like, one time in the airplane, someone might just go drunk and just hit people. She said, yeah, we have stories like that. I'm like, and you continue selling? Like, I'm telling you, like, wake up, yani, it's dangerous. She says, you know what? I can't do anything about it. She can. Leave the job. Ar-Razzaaq will provide for you. Only if she knew Ar-Razzaaq, that she would have never said that. Leave that job. Don't sell alcohol. Bismillah, move forward. Ardullah wasi'ah. Allah will provide for you. Allah will never let go of you. Believe in Allah Ar-Razzaaq. Don't humble yourself to that extent and humiliate yourself. Dhul for money. Allah is the one who provides. Wallahi, the money she just took from that position, let's say it's $500 for example, $500 was written. It was written as rizq. But she chose to get it from the haram resource. When had she waited, she would have got it from the halal resource. So with that, inshallah, we'll continue next episodes with Allah's beautiful name, Ar-Razzaq. May Allah reward you for your patience. I hope the confidence of yours went up to the next level. It's not the human beings who provide, it's Allah Ar-Razzaq. It is only if you know Allah Ar-Razzaq that we will feel that sense of confidence and we will have always that dignity and honor and not humble to ourselves and humiliate to any other human being. Barakallah feekum, jazakumullah khair. We'll see you next episode. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So let's make up our minds to do the right thing in this life. In our chants, Allah's name do we sing. Allah, Allah, Allah. Ya Allah. When we step out of our homes in the middle of the day, do we ever think, when's the end of my stay? Someone dies in the news right in front of your face. Do we ever think, when's my turn in the grave? To read all the tales of the kings of the past, do we ever think, how long did it last? Day after day,